it took me about a year to decide, because I was very critical of fraternities, because I hadn't had any, I didn't know anything about black fraternities. I knew something about the white fraternities. I think I told you something about it earlier. Some of you were here. You had the University of Richmond. I mean, they were elitist, racist, politically reactionary, and I belonged in at the University of Richmond to an organization, a literary society, which was anti-fraternity. Now, well, I didn't want the Sigmas to be like those fraternities. And a little bit they are. You know, I mean, they are also to some, there's an elitist element. I mean, I'm against elitism. But I gradually was convinced that the Sigmas and the Liberals were doing good work, and they supported me and what I was doing in the NAACP, so I gave in and joined them.
And so if it had not been for your relationship with the NAACP, do you think you would have joined?
Probably not, no. Of course, later on there were other organizations like CORE and so on. And I always sat for the NAACP. NAACP, I think, was a moderate organization. Maybe in some ways even too moderate. But of course, I was in the term about 25 years ago of the, who was this guy who was for a short time president, who wanted to make it into a sort of all-black organization. But he was, he didn't last more than a few months. And you know when that was.
See, okay.
Which one was Chavez?
Yeah, I think so.
Chavez?
Yeah. And, of course, the NAACP from the very beginning was biracial. You know, when it was founded in 1909, it was a biracial organization. It was not a black organization, it was a biracial organization. Of course, Du Bois was one of the founders, and Spindown. And in the North, whites, and especially Jews, always played an active part in the NAACP. And Little Rock, I was a little different. Little Rock was an all-black organization, but not because they wanted to be all-black. Because there were no whites who would work with them. And of course, when they asked me to work with them, I worked with them. And then a few years later, Dr. Lodge came, and of course, he was very active in the NAACP too. Nice thing about Dr. Lodge was, you know, the Citizens Council, you know, the Racist Citizen Council, had all of these public announcements in bad English. And the NAACP had all of its announcements in perfect English. And the guy who wrote these NAACP announcements was Dr. Lee Lodge. And, I mean, we were on a much higher intellectual level than these white races. And I think that also helped to convince some whites.